Good evening, everyone. So we are back with our live sessions. So today we have our guest, Shivam Singh, who is Manit alumni. I'll give a brief introduction about Shivam sir, then we'll proceed. So Shivam sir is Manit alumni. He did his B.Tech from Manit. Then after that, he took admission in M.Tech. He completed his master's from Manit. Then he went for pursuing PhD from IIT Indore, and currently is pursuing PhD from IIT Indore. So welcome Shivam sir on our live sessions.
Good evening everyone, and thank you Yasveer for inviting me. I'm glad to be the part of this live sessions, and I'm happy to be with all of you. Thank you for.
So, sir, today we got one interesting question from one of our viewers that does science come from spirituality, or is it man-made?
Yeah.
Or made by man? So we'll take this question. So actually this question is asked from one of the viewers whose name is Abhishek, and he's from Bhopal. So we would like to continue with this topic. So, sir, what are your views on this thing?
So, basically, Yasveer, it's a very nice question, especially so many youths, they are so much confused about spirituality, religion. Nowadays, we are seeing outside. So, the people, they don't have proper understanding what it is and how they are differing with each other. What are the similarities between spirituality, religion, science, and so many other things. So first of all, I would like to explain spirituality. Spirituality is basically coming from spiritual. And spiritual is what? Spirit plus ritual. Sometimes whatever we do as a ritual, people, they consider it as a spirituality, but they don't get the spirit behind that. So that spirit, it what? We are explaining in today's world like science. So this is what basically the science behind all these rituals. So this is what spiritual actually mean. And spirituality is what? Which is talking about spirit and which is talking about spiritual topics. So this is what the brief explanation about what spirituality is. And another things like this question which you have raised, or which Abhishek has asked from Bhopal, like he's confused about whether this spirituality or this science is a subset of spirituality, or man-made or something. So first we'll talk about science. What science is? Science is what basically it dealings with so many physical phenomena which is already existing. For example, if you take gravitation or gravity, or friction. So these are natural phenomena which are existing, but the concept or mathematical postulations which has been derived, that has been done by these people, that has been done by the researchers or the scientists, mathematicians. So at least we can reach up to this conclusion that this science or the books which has been written on science has been given by the human. At least this conclusion we can derive out of it. This, at least the science is man-made. Now coming to the question whether spirituality is or not, or whether it's a subset of it or not. So talking about the subset, see, spirituality is basically the study of totality of reality. And science is a study of just a physical world, a physical phenomena of this reality. And in physical reality also, especially the measurable reality. So this is what basically the science is. So the another thing, like I explain you that in science also, when we deal with the concepts, when we deal with these realities, these physical realities, then also we make some postulations, we make some mathematical concepts. So that is what basically, when we understand spirituality is what basically the spirituality words especially denotes for consciousness. And consciousness is what? It is coming from soul. And the basic understanding of this spirituality or consciousness is what? The longing for understanding. And longing for understanding means what? This is what the basically we can say the developed consciousness. Like, for example, if you take example of humans and animals. Animals, they doesn't have any type of developed consciousness. They have consciousness, but if you take like materials, they don't even have consciousness also. But animals, they have consciousness, but it is not developed. So they cannot ask, they cannot understand. They don't have that longing for understanding, which is the function, basic function of consciousness. And consciousness is what basically the spirituality is. So in spirituality, we try to understand things. This basically the concept from where we are trying to understanding all these things is coming. Like we talk about gravity, for example. Like very example and a very important tendency, and we get into imagine like our teachers when they talk about this gravity. So they give us this story of Newton, that Newton was sitting under a tree and then an apple falls down. So he started thinking about why it is falling. If you can imagine an animal in that picture, what he would be thinking about? He would be just catching that apple and he would be enjoying that. Means, yeah. Or whatever that animal is it or not? So this is what the difference which is making, the developed consciousness, which is making that person to think about why it is happening, what is the reason behind that, what I can do in it, how I can contribute in it. So this is what the function of that developed consciousness is. And this is what the basically this spirituality is. So spirituality is just to go for deeper and deeper understanding. Like so many people, they get confused in this basic terminology of spirituality. Sometimes they explain it that going deep into something, that this is what basically the science is, the spirituality. So sometimes it becomes like little confusing. What is science? What is spirituality? But here we are defining it, what the basic thing, the longing for understanding. And that longing for understanding may lead to what? Spiritual understanding as well as scientific understanding. It depends on you, whether in which direction you want to go for that scientific understanding of that or a spiritual understanding of that. But basic thing is what we can understand here, that spirituality is what the understanding of totality of reality, whether the science is just dealing with physical reality. So basically physical reality is the subset of total reality. In total reality, so many other things also exist beyond this physical phenomena. So from this understanding, we can understand that the science is a subset of spirituality, but definitely the focus for science and the focus for spirituality is different. So this is what the basic explanation which we can derive out of this question, that what is spirituality is and what science is and where it is going to.
Okay, so basically what I understood, sir, that mainly the science is explanation which is given by human, or you can say observatory things that human thought of why it is happening. And the reason why a human and animal, suppose you gave the example, like you gave the example of apple falling, a human tends to think why this apple is falling, because there is trigger from inside, which we called as consciousness. That consciousness, being conscious, we have thought processing, and that thought processing led to make some kind of like questioning in our mind, that further lead to this development of explanation of the things which were already existing. So basically the will, which is provided by the consciousness, which we call as spirituality. And what the explanation is given by human. So when we see this with the perspective of like human directly, not going this behind this, then we see as the science is like just human made or man made. But when we see the back thing, like how a human has this question, has trigger in that his mind, because animal is also watching that apple falling. So this is what I understood. And second thing you told that basically science is a subset which explains the nature. Definitely it's explaining the nature, that when we want to understand that nature completely, then we have to consider the part which is spirituality. So sir, thank you for that. And I just have one question in my mind, that as you are a research scholar, and so you are like big in the sense you are much more ahead in science, because normally you have completed your bachelor's, then master's, and then you are doing PhD, that too from a renowned college. This is IIT Indore. So just I have a query, that how, sir, you involve this spirituality in your research work? Because this research, what you are doing, it's actually science. So how does it relate? How does it help? So can you like give some explanation on that, so that we could understand? Yes, science is taking help of some spirituality part, and that spiritual things are helpful for a science student also. So sir, over to you.
Yeah, actually, Yasveer, you have raised another very important point here. Like in today's world, people, they talk about IQs. So many questions are there. Like even the companies, they are coming, they want to check, means who's having the best IQ. New parameters are coming, how they can define the IQ, the intellectual part of that person, and how they are able to solve the problem. But nowadays, I have been observing, and it is the demand of the industries also. Now they have started working on emotional quotient and spiritual quotient also. This emotional quotient is basically the subset of spiritual quotient only. Now people, they are understanding the importance of spirituality. They are giving importance to the spiritual values also. So now the demand for is emotional quotient, how people they behave when they are on, especially when if they are working in a very big firm, very big, big multinational companies. So their spiritual quotient should be very high. How much they are faithful to the company, because they are dealing with the secrets of the companies. So it's very much important. So nowadays, the companies, they want to test a spiritual quotient. They want to test emotional quotient of that person also. So definitely it is. And you know, like so many people nowadays, they are so much encouraging, and that you have to take care of your mental health also. You have to take care of your brain, your mind also. So basically, how you can train your mind, this is what basically the spirituality talks about, that how basically how you can nourish your intelligence. And nourishing intelligence means giving a proper food to the intelligence, and giving proper food to the intelligence basically is what giving it something higher. Okay, so that something higher is what, when you go beyond this physical phenomena, when you go beyond this observatory worlds in which we are dealing, in which basically the science is dealing. So this is what, when you get to know about so many things, and when you practically implement those things in your life, you feel so much helpful. You feel so much relaxed. Like nowadays, so many spiritual practices are there. People, they are doing yoga. People, they are doing meditations. And they're getting benefited a lot. And this has been popularly adopted all over the world. Not even in scientific community, but all over the world, in all the classes, people, they are following this spirituality, and it is really helping the people in understanding the things. And even I have seen the people, those are very actively involved in physics, very actively involved in chemistry, they are becoming more and more spiritual, because when they go into the deep, when they get to, when they start like going into the deeper of the science, atomics, and then going into the nucleons, then going into the electron and protons, then they start thinking, oh, is there something beyond this, and how these things are happening, or what is the reason behind that? So when they go into the deep, so they understand the spiritual aspect also. They appreciate this point also. So I have seen, I have went into the biography of so many scientists. So definitely it is helping, and it will be helping to the generations of each and every kind, each and every class throughout. So spirituality is really playing a very important role for each and every individual. This is my personal experience as a researcher, as a student, and as a human.
Okay. Yeah, I also have seen like companies, they see capability, but other part they consider character as one of the most prominent thing in a candidate. So being like, how we can develop a character, you must have a strong spiritual credits, or we can say teachings in your life. Another part also, like we have heard that a state of mind can be best or worst for you, because whatever you do and whatever the result comes, it depends on the state of mind what you are having. So definitely we see lot many things, like in Bhagavad Gita also we see how we like work on the controlling of our mind. So because this mind can be a friend and also an enemy. Like a science is a science. This can be used in best way and can also be used in worst way. So definitely, sir, we are very thankful to you that you gave such a nice explanations, and we have lot of clarity in now this question that how science is. So just I want, sir, you to give a conclusion statement over this topic, so we'll bind up our session. So sir, over to you.
Okay, so in conclusion, I would like to mention, like, the basic question is what first I told, that what is spirituality is. So I told the spiritual, and then I divided it in two parts, spirit plus ritual. Sometimes people, they consider only ritual as a spirituality or spiritual things, but the spirit they forget. So that spirit is very much required to know about, then only you can understand spirituality in a realistic manner. Then the another point, which the main question was whether this spirituality, the science is a subset of spirituality, or means whether it's a man-made or something, this spirituality. So in that I have explained, like, basically we all have this understanding that this science is not something else, and it, these things are existing, the physical phenomena which we are studying, like friction, gravity, and so many things we have been explaining mathematically, or scientists, researchers, they have been explaining all these things, but these things were already existing. So the science is basically what dealing with basically a part of reality, the physical reality of this world. But the spirituality is the study of totality of reality. And then we went into the details that what spirituality is. Spirituality is what it is coming from the consciousness. Consciousness is being derived from the soul, and the function of soul is what the basically this consciousness is, what to understand the things. Your longing for understanding is what basically your consciousness is, your developed consciousness is for that. Then we differed ourselves from humans, that why humans have developed this science, why not these animals, because they are also existing from the millennium. So this is what the things which is making different, and this developed consciousness which is coming out of this longing for understanding, and this longing for understanding can further be went into these two parts, whether it is for spiritual understanding and whether it is for scientific understanding. But the function, basic function which is being derived from it, from that, is from that consciousness. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes. So thank you very much, sir. Thank you all viewers. I hope you might now have better understanding over this. So we will be continuing our sessions. So we'll meet you soon. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you for giving us.
Thank you, everyone. I hope I would have explained it more nicely, but I thought means I have done my best, and I think that now you'd be having a clear understanding about what is spirituality is and what science is, and how they are differing with each other, and how they are aligned with each other, and how spirituality is important for all of us, how it is important in each and every lives. And thank you, Yasveer, again for giving me this opportunity to come and to share my personal views here, whatever I have read from scriptures, Bhagavad Gita and all. So thank you, everyone, for joining us. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, everyone. We'll meet you soon. Bye-bye.